Welcome to ESPN College Football, the Valero Alamo City Bowl. Tonight, number 21 Missouri out of the Big 12 Conference takes on number 23 Northwestern from the Big 10. Villarreal prepares to kick it off for Northwestern. The Big 10 against the Big 12, and here it is, a high pooch kick coming down at the 25-yard line. And a return of only 2 yards. Jimmy Jackson, one of the upbacks,
put Missouri back on the map. Chase Daniel has helped raise it another notch. 2 years in a row, Big 12 North champions.
From the customary shotgun with an empty backfield, the Tigers to throw on first down. Too high. Complete, which means four to the top of your screen. That's him that comes back toward the line in motion. And now hand it off to him, and he'll go for a couple of yards, and then that's it. And his Northwestern crowd loving third down in the line to make. He's out at the 38. Chase Daniel. Good protection. Got a man, throws it to guess who? Kaufman is tight end. He's going to have the first down according to where the official has marked it across the way. By about a half a yard, he will have the first. Kaufman is such a huge, wonderful target. I mean, it is almost without saying who you're going to go to. You go to him.
And I don't know that there's a player in the country with a better set of hands. I was talking to Dave Christensen, the offensive coordinator for Missouri, who, of course, after this ball game, will take off to be the head coach at Wyoming. And he said, Ed, I've never seen him drop a pass, forget in games, but even in practice. And I think this young man's going to go to an NFL team and become a really productive NFL tight end. He's a solid blocker, not a great blocker. But that set of hands and how well he moves in space for how big he is, he's going to have a long, long NFL career.
Well, referee Jack Christensen says it is first down. And we have talked about him before. Prejudice, yes, he is a good friend. Jack Childress, I think, certainly the best of the ACC and one of the best officials in the country. I think he, along with Steve Shaw and a couple of other guys, are on a plateau all their own. First down from the 39. They fake the run. Middle screen. And here's Macklin. First time tonight. And you can see the crowd just becomes electric when he touches the ball.
Finding different ways to get number 9 the ball. He leads the nation in all-purpose yardage.
Second down. Daniel, far sideline, throws this one complete. And that's to Tommy Saunders. This is the moderate flow. They go with the running play. Washington, whoa, he gets smacked down on first down.
Quintang did a really nice job of stepping his game up when they lost his linebacker man.
Daniel, here comes pressure. Rolls to his right, going to run it. Now, he pumped it, and there was nobody even on that side of the field. And then come to Missouri and emerge as a truly outstanding quarterback. Forget 6 feet tall. He's a winner. Throws the pass a little too high. Intercepted, picked off by Brian Peters, redshirt freshman out of Pickerington, Ohio. C.J. Bechet comes in at quarterback, the senior out of Sacramento, and Tyrell Sutton is back, and here he goes on the first carry, and you see what a lightning bolt.
And when he wasn't able to play, you could just see the wind come out of the sails of Northwestern. He is a difference maker for them on offense.
Peterman in motion, pass goes to the other side, and boy, what a wallop, but it's a first down as the who could be looking at the NFL draft. Bechet, quick look in, got it again, and undoubtedly they like that underbelly. And
dummy signals, that is.
Dummy signals is what you know what I was referring to. Straight ahead, Sutton, and I don't think Sutton has it. It's going to be very close.
I think you'd go for it on fourth down at this point of the field.
Under center this time for Bechet. Woodson comes in at fullback. Sutton, with the block of Woodson, takes it straight ahead for the Northwestern first down. I would not want to be in space with a one-on-one situation with him. Going to go long. Deep over the middle. Got a man open at the 10, at the 5. Eric Peterman, end zone. Touchdown, Northwestern. The extra point attempt. rips it right down the middle. So let's go to break. And one more look. C.J. Bechet throws a perfect strike. Peterman into the end zone, and it's the Wildcats, 7-0. Just do what we do, and we'll be fine in this ballgame. High spinner. Fair catch is called for and made the field, this time trailing 7-0. And he'll hand it off to Washington. Washington stumbles, then gets helped to the turf.
For Dave Christensen, the offensive coordinator, they're going to go fast again.
Washington has five, and then gets whacked down at the 41. Not only a good fellow, good coach. Mm-hmm. Third down, line to make the 46. Pass over the middle. That is not going to be enough for the first down. Fourth down, Jake Harry prepares to kick it in the left footer. Well, this is a driving spiral, driving Smith all the way back to the 10-yard line. And Brendan Wisely, I was not even born, Jack. We won't go there anymore. Running play, and it's Sutton this time. Boy, he gets whacked down hard. That ball, did it come loose at the 11-yard line? Second down and nine. Here comes pressure. Pass knocked away on a nice defensive stop. And that's Sean Weatherspoon. Third down, line to make is the 20. Sutton resets, and they throw to him out of the backfield. Great play. 20, 25, 30. He's loose. William Moore makes the stop as the ball came loose. First down, Missouri. There is a flag back at the line of scrimmage. We were all looking 44 yards down the field. The play is also under review.
After
the call.
Review, it was confirmed that there was a fumble and it was recovered by the defense. However, there is offside by the defense. That penalty will be accepted.
See, that's
5 yards.
You got to lose about 39 yards, but who cares? You got the football. Simmons in the ball game at tailback, and he has joined the quarterback behind the line of scrimmage. Flag as Peterman gets the pass, and he will have the first down.
And now they can run any play they want. This is not going well.
You're right. Play calling is a lot different here. They pull the guard for protection. Bechet cuts in front of his blocker, then fights forward for about 5 yards. Okay, Reese, thanks so much. Look forward to visiting with you over the course of the night. Blitz up the middle. They throw a corner screen, and Tyrell Sutton puts a hand down, maintains his balance. It is third down. If they want to keep it going, they have to take it to the 34-yard line. Wildcats lead it 7-0. Bechet has a man, and what a catch at the 38-yard line.
Really settled him down. He seemed to really focus in at the end of the season for us.
Sutton rode him into the line, and then Stephen Simmons, a reserve tailback. He is at the very bottom of your screen, and Missouri needs to keep an eye because of the five wide receivers. He's going to get single attention. They throw it back into the middle, trying to throw that bubble screen, and nothing doing.
Player by the January 15th deadline.
Ninth play of the drive. Bechet intercepted at the 45-yard line by Brock Christopher. Couldn't hold on. I beg your pardon. Here's the left footer. Well, this is another really nice punt. Fair catch is called for back at the 15-yard line
of the season. BCS or not, that's going to be a fun game to watch.
Chase Daniel throws the pass complete to Tommy Saunders, and Saunders being pushed back. And
except on third down scenarios, he's going down 1-57 right now.
On second down, throws to a wide open receiver on the sideline, and that is Alexander.
For the last couple of years, shouldn't be much of a drop-off except personnel-wise.
Daniel throws this one complete to Tommy Saunders, and he's going to be hit. Situation, they didn't score. Longhorns did, and then all of a sudden they became impatient. Daniel finds a man. He's got Kaufman at the 42. And that is short.
Had too many turnovers. He had 8 interceptions in their 4 losses. So they talked about him forcing. He doesn't look like he's forcing it so far tonight.
Blitz off the corner. Daniel's going to run it.
He'll have enough for the first down and a lot more. And that right there is something that people are surprised at.
74%, but both of them can tuck and run really well.
Pass too high at the 30-yard line as Missouri really played hurry up.
Around the country from here in Texas, we talked about it all season, Ron. The 7-on-7 drill in high school has changed football in this state forever.
Andrew Jones being pushed back, and he is a huge proponent of what it does for everybody, offensive and defensive, the 7-on-7 competition and drills. Throws another one complete to Tommy Saunders, and out of bounds at the 25.
Spread, so why try to reinvent what these young men are learning at that level?
Quick out pass into the flat. There's Macklin. Gets by one, gets by two. Tackle going to be made very close to the first down.
I have never seen this much offense. A team can run formations and plays.
Derek Washington takes the ball for the first down inside the 15. And he wants to look good tonight, not just for his family, but for everybody in the state of Texas who has enjoyed his talents for so many years.
So the coach with him at Colorado said, you need to hire this guy.
12th play of the drive. It started at the 15-yard line, and there's Macklin, and he slides down after the reception. That is the end of the first quarter. And as we take a timeout, the Wildcats of Northwestern, huge underdogs in this ball game, leading 7-0. But the Cats of Missouri, threatening. Look at Daniel on this drive, 8 of 9, 56 yards, 13th play of the drive coming up right here. Daniel steps up. Gets it away, deep in the end zone, overthrows it. Alexander was the closest. 31 yards will be the attempt. Plenty of distance on a kick and plenty of accuracy, and we've got a 7-3 ball game.
But he's got great quickness on his throws. He's accurate, and we've seen how good of an athlete he is here tonight.
Here's Wolford's kickoff end, going to come down to the 3, and Simmons on the return. Wow, what a, that was on the ankle tackle. Opening moments of the second quarter. Tyrell Sutton back in the ballgame at tailback, and he'll get the handoff. Right side, has 5, and is going to be tripped up.
This year, the last 4 ball games with that wrist, he was really a hard worker in the training room as well. With a good game, but imagine the numbers he would have put up if he hadn't battled those injuries last 2 years.
Straight ahead right here for the first down.
And again, with that wrist injury, he's still able to run, get on the bike, do all of those things. So he's in good shape.
Well, Bechet got a high pass from center. I think that was supposed to be a handoff, but he did the wise thing.
Next week, the next game, he laid out the guy that laid him out. He was 13.
This pass thrown complete and stepping out of bounds, it is Andrew Brewer. It is a 3rd down. They need 2 yards to pick up the first. Wildcats lead it 7-3. Pressure, ball thrown complete, broken tackle. 15, 20, and now 25 yards beyond the broken tackle. Wound up as a 30-yard gain. Going to be a double. Peterman wants to throw, and he is going to be sacked at the 33. What a great defensive effort. Well, now it is 2nd down and huge. You got to take it all the way to the 12-yard line. Bechet, screen, left side. Sutton inside the 15. He's all the way down to the 12-yard line. Forget how far they had to pick up. But they check a fullback into the game again as they go under center. That's Woodson. Keeps the ball, and the ball thrown a little too high. But that may be defensive holding.
Missouri all year, they had such high.
The new line of scrimmage is the 4-yard line of Missouri. 9th play of the drive. It started back at the 20th end. 5. Bechet holds on to the football, and he was knifed under.
Everything go that happened during the season that was disappointing. Everyone else needs to step up.
2nd down, Bechet. Here comes pressure. Throws it for the corner of the end zone and just threw it away. Sean Weatherspoon. Nice catch, Gus. 3rd down. 3rd down and goal. Northwestern. Bechet
going to run. At the 5-yard line, is shoved out of bounds, and there was a flag across the way. And on huge play.
The first one.
Offside, number two of the defense, half the distance to the goal line. Repeat third down.
Well, let's see. It is third down again, and the ball about 2.5 yards away. Bichet looks, throws for the end zone. Nobody there, incomplete. Villarreal, 19 of 23 this year. In his career, 32 of 42, and this one's going to be placed down from 21 yards away. And he rips it through, and we again have a 7-point ball game. Northwestern now on top, 10 to 3, with 9:11 left until halftime. Here comes the kick. And it's a high poocher, high and a quick spinner. Ball is caught at the 34 by Jackson. And he will bring it to the 43-yard line. First and 10 for the Missouri Tigers as they go from their own 43-yard line. I believe this is their best starting position of the night. Daniel, they double the reverse, and here comes Macklin. And finally going to be smacked down, but it's after a gain of 10.
But now his teammate.
Chase Daniel with the first down, and this time across midfield. Pressure off the corner on the blitz, has to throw it away, and it's intercepted at the 49-yard line by Wooten. Second turnover, and boy, look at the Northwestern bench. And the man who caused it just had.
Looks to me, the key is that right arm. Does it get up underneath the ball?
Boy, that's awesome.
Yeah, I don't see it hit the ground.
I don't think so either, but it's very hard to tell because of the darkness of the jersey and the football.
After review, the call on the field stands. Interception, first down.
Can raise you an outside linebacker in an interception.
Something spinning and wound up with a couple of yards. If most people would have been stuck back to the line of scrimmage. C.J. Boucher, quick pass behind the line of scrimmage. Peterman makes the catch and takes it to the 41.
They've improved by over 11 points per game given up over last year.
Here comes the blitz, and they go straight ahead with the run, and they'll have the first down.
May not be drafted high. There's going to be questions about his durability, but I also think he's going to have a long time here as well.
Boucher right over the middle has it complete. There's Sutton again out of the backfield this time. He was right on. He was truthful, wasn't he? That pass goes incomplete. 6 of 8 on third down conversions for Northwestern. Boucher rolls the pocket, throws the pass a little high, and because of that, the hit.
So let's see. His well within his range.
As long as this year, 46 against Ohio University. This one is going to be about a half yard longer than that, but they may say officially 46 on this one as well. Waits for the pass, gets a good one. He's got tons of distance, and it is wide left and no good. A lot of distance, but not a lot of accuracy on that one.
Maybe see something unleashed a little deeper, though. Try to stretch this defense a bit.
In other words, go vertical now.
Mm-hmm.
Daniel, quick out. Throws it a little high, but they got it to Macklin, and there he goes, but he steps out of bounds. He said he was not intimidated by Jeremy Macklin. And now a direct snap comes to Macklin. Turns the corner, and Macklin will go down. He'll have the first down.
That extra couple of weeks of preparation has really helped Northwestern.
Wooten looks really good. Pass near sideline has this one complete. And Northwestern trying to rip the ball away from Jared Perry. Wooden with pressure, pass to the near sideline is caught, and then stepping out of bounds with the first down is Tommy Saunders.
We have illegal touching. Mm-hmm. Number 84 of the offense went out of bounds voluntarily, was first to touch the pass. The penalty is a loss of down at the previous spot, third down.
Yeah. 10-3, Wildcats lead it. Missouri got it incomplete. It was thrown behind Saunders. Himself to a fake. And he can run with the ball and then kick, and it's the Australian rules kick. And here's what happens. Oh, it is picked up. Most of the time, Peterman picked it up.
But that was a good heads-up play because I think that would have gone down well inside the 5 had he not grabbed it.
Boucher looks up, throws the pass, incomplete at the 15-yard line. Now he pauses again. They still have 14 seconds. Sutton straight ahead, winding, spinning, out over the 15-yard line. Well, they certainly had it early, and then we thought the Tigers took it away as Bechet throws it complete, and that is enough for the first down. Just
Missouri not quite wanting to be here. Northwestern really happy to be here.
Sutton hit hard at the line of scrimmage, fights his way.
Legal contact with an agent that caused that is just a shame. You don't need that type of contact.
Pitchback comes to Sutton, turns the corner. He is close to another first down. But he puts it in the stomach of Sutton, and
play clock go all the way down to 4 and 5 seconds almost every time.
Boy, Sutton running hard. He got banged equally as hard. They still have 7 seconds right now. Bechet has the ball caught. Complete first down at the 45, Rashid Ward.
10, 12 seconds on that 40-second clock.
Bechet going to go long. Far sideline. Well, maybe a half step. Stephen Simmons, number 25, a 5'8 sophomore, comes in a tailback. Pressure again, and he's going to be set at the 35-yard line. It's Shula. They're going to take it all the way to the 44 of the Tigers. And here's Sutton. Sutton runs hard, but he's not anywhere close, and it will be punting time. What? And the left footer delivers, and it is a partial spiral on the run. Macklin, 30, 35. Here he goes. 45. Kiss him goodbye. Count it off. 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, 75 yards. Pat Fitzgerald, you knew better. You just got burned. So with 1 minute exactly left in this first half, we got a brand new ball game, and we are tied at 10.
That thing on the ground, and it caught a little spiral and hung.
With about a minute to play and a half, kick it out of bounds. Who cares?
Yeah, that's a good point.
Well, this return from 2 yards deep, got to be by Simmons. And Simmons cut back into the traffic rather than staying outside. Northwestern, they'll keep it on the ground, and Sutton will go for very short yardage. That's a new record, 75 yards on the punt return by Jeremy Macklin. Simmons hit behind the line, breaks out of it, still running. Boy, what a good second and third effort. So we got a tie ball game. It did not appear it was going to be that way, but the momentum was grabbed away on that return. Our halftime score, Northwestern 10 and Missouri 10. High, deep kick coming down to the 3-yard line. This is Simmons, and Simmons will be stopped at the 20-yard line.
Got them to forget about that punt.
Bechet with a first down at the 20. Gives it to Sutton. It's going to be a gain of 5, now 6 yards.
It was the recipe for the 4 losses for Missouri.
Did that side of the line move prematurely?
75 offense.
Yep, it's going to be Al Netter, the redshirt freshman. And for people who have always observed from afar, thinking that maybe middle linebackers may not be very bright, you're wrong. Bechet throws it complete. That's good for the first down.
He has to walk up and play that slot. He's more of a safety type guy.
Gonna pass on first down, and he's got it again. Peterman. And this is going to be another first down. Let me say this. One of those interceptions, though, I felt like was a poorly run route by the Missouri Tiger. There is another pass, virtually the same, not quite the distance. Rashid Ward. Kafka in that Minnesota game had 217 yards rushing. Gives it to Sutton straight ahead. You know, Sutton breaks the tackle.
Easy. Let's trash them once more.
Oh, God. Gonna go on top. Has a man. Touchdown, Rashid Ward.
in all of college football showing their cracks.
Villarreal, and he hit the upright. How big is that? Hit the upright to the right. And with 12:08 left to play in the third quarter, all of a sudden the glee over a 46-yard touchdown is diminished as he misses an extra point. One more look as we go to break. You can see Guinness being beaten here and beaten badly. Let's take a timeout.
So you think this team is focused? They look a lot more focused than Missouri.
Here comes the high short spinner. And it's going to be caught at the 32-yard line by Jackson. And Jackson hardly moved out of his tracks.
For Missouri.
Chase Daniel hides it behind the back. Going to go on top. Going long and overthrown for Jared Perry.
It was bad all the way around.
Well, the corner is a sophomore. The safety is a freshman. And here's Macklin on the end around. And Macklin's going to have the first down, I believe. Three wide receivers right, one to the left, lobs it right over the middle, has it complete, and that's good for the first down. Number 26, a redshirt freshman out of St. Louis, Hazelwood Central, into the backfield. Rolls to his right, throws back to the left, and has it complete. Finally gained control. That's Kaufman. Daniel trying to get that offense going again. Looking, got plenty of time now under pressure. Throws it complete at the 30, runs into his own man.
A good job of mirroring his quarterback.
Washington back at a tailback. He'll get the handoff at the 30, spins around, still fighting, and he'll be with about 4 yards on the play.
Battle being won up front by the purple guys.
Play action, pumped it once. Now looking for the left side, throws it, and there's Kaufman. Kaufman. Daniel steps up, throws it complete, and the tackle is made. He's short of the first down. And he takes it up the middle, and Daniel belted down hard at the 11, but he has the first down, plus everything tonight for the most part. There was a three and out back early, but has been long drives. Here's Washington. He's hit behind the line of scrimmage, and he may fight his way back to the line. Throws for the end zone, has a man there, he caught it out of bounds. He was there, but the pass was thrown just a smidgen late.
That is a size mismatch for Faye.
Fakes it to the left, got a man over the middle, throws for the touchdown, Alexander. Now understand one thing, if we're playing percentages here, Missouri should take the lead.
Accuracy leader to passing John Lee of UCLA.
He just got it, and they take the lead by one. That, by the way, the 100th touchdown pass by Chase Daniel in his career. Take a timeout. Tigers go on top, 17-16. They wait for the pooch quick kick. And they kick it away. High spinner going to come down short. Simmons at the 8-yard line. And a deep flag comes down from holding Wildcats. That's on Franklin, Ed Cunningham, and Jack Arute coming to you from the Valero Alamo Bowl. Pitch back, and it's Sutton on the option play, and he gets bowled out of bounds. But
this guy is a player.
Quick out pass, got a blocker in front, and the ball is dropped by Brewer. Three wide receivers left, two to the right. Third down, they need to take it to the 28. Got a man, and the ball is caught. He juggled it, and then Rashid Ward came down with the football.
And that ball in the air, it looked like he should have been able to make a play on it.
First down from the 40, option play. They pitch it back to Sutton. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. And second down and 12. If you just joined us, 17-16, the Missouri Tigers. This pass caught at the 42-yard line by Brewer. He is shoved out of bounds immediately. Okay, Jack, they are 9 of 13 on third down conversions. They got to take this one to midfield. Good protection. Got it. Deep intercepted over the middle by Christopher. And Christopher down the sideline against some blockers. Finally going to be tackled at the 30-yard line of Northwestern.
Boucher comes up hobbling a little bit. Touchdown against Nebraska. So Christopher very good at hiding himself. Quarterback can't see him.
Running play, and it's going to go inside the 30. That's Tommy Saunders with the ball.
That one there, he just didn't recognize the linebacker coming from the backside.
Daniel under pressure. Going to try to run. And now he's going to have to. And boy, he gets whacked out of bounds. Jackson blocking. Goes for the end zone. Deep. Caught out of bounds. Macklin caught the ball and squarely came down out of bounds.
On the outside, and that's just a really nice job by Jordan Maben, a true freshman who had to step up when they lost Justin Vaughn running stride for stride. Good recognition by Maben.
Field goal attempt is going to be 43 yards. Jeff Wolford, the senior out of Overland Park, plenty of distance. He's got a great leg, and he splits him. And the Tigers add to their lead. Now they move out to 20-16 at the 3:46 mark of the third quarter. And he looked up to see where the receivers are. There's one on the goal line, and that's where he kicks it. Deep to that side. That's Simmons from the two. Simmons, well, a nice job defensively on the special team. Boucher going to go on top, and he overthrows this time. The safety came over. They sent him down to 10.
Can't leave your feet like that.
Gives it to Sutton. Has a little bit of an opening in the middle, and the Tigers stop him after a gain of about 2.5.
One player did that, Jeremy Macklin.
On third down, needs to go to the 40. Here comes pressure. Boucher is knocked down and sacked at the 27 by Ziggy Hood.
We have illegal substitution, 12 men in the formation on the offense. 5-yard penalty and still fourth down.
It's being shown on the part of the Wildcats. Here's the boot, and he kicked it to him again. From the 40-yard line, gets a block. Now here comes a flag, and he is down at the 42.
Return, illegal block in the back, 31 of the offense. That's a 10-yard penalty, spot of the foul, first down.
That's Macklin, and they hand it off to him on the end around. Turns it up at the 30, 35, at the 40. Flag comes from deep downfield. And
holding, 81 of the offense, 10-yard penalty, spot of the foul, repeat first down.
Daniel, good protection. Quick pass, intercepted on the corner, Brad Phillips. Just stepped right in front. Locked in on him and stayed on him. First down, Northwestern. They have the ball inside the 25. And a screen thrown to Sutton. And what a defensive play. I'm going to give you 10 tries.
At it right in half.
Both have had just a huge impact on their side of the ball. Pass thrown complete. That's Sutton. He'll only have 1 yard on the play. Empty backfield. C.J. Boucher with a third down. They got to take it all the way to the 14.5. Goes for the end zone. And the ball is caught. Was he inbounds? Yes. Touchdown, Northwestern. Ross Lee.
And Northwestern quickly runs out. One, try to kick it before they get to review this. And two, don't go for two yet. It's way too early in the game to go for two. That is a touchdown. Yep, he controlled it when he hit the ground. That's, remember, the ground can't cause a fumble, but it can cause an incomplete pass. And that ball was controlled all the way through the land. Great play by Ross Lane.
After review,
here we go.
The call on the field, stand. Touchdown.
Now, Northwestern sprints back out on the field. Well, he got this one, I mean, right down the heart. So we'll hold it right here with 31 ticks left on the clock.
Who he coached under, 4-8 his first year, 6-6 last year, 9-4 in his first bowl game this year. It's a pretty good improvement season to season.
This is Macklin, and Macklin is slowed up at the 20 and tackled at the 24.
Not only his mentor, but a very good friend, Gary Barnett.
Well, they go with a running play, and it's going to be Derek Washington, and that is for your hustle, your desire, and your character. This time, big opening. Running play is going to go for a first down. Brendan Smith. That is the end of the third quarter. So let's take a timeout as Northwestern sprints to the other end of the field. As we go to the fourth and final 15 minutes, it's the Wildcats of Northwestern 23 and the Tigers of Missouri 20. Don't go away. In fact, call a neighbor. We'll be right back. So we are back 23-20 as we start the fourth quarter. Really touching moment and a highly, highly thought of young man. Lost too quickly. Lost a battle to lymphomas. That ball is overthrown down at the 28 to be fine. Well, to back up your point on the touchdown drive they had in this half, as you look at Washington, has five. Is going to wind up with about 6 yards. Back now. Daniel steps up. Gets the ball away. He just throws it away, and it is going to be a fourth down.
All right.
Brendan Smith, the deep man. Now keep in mind, he is capable of taking it a long way, but he has to call a fair catch on this one. The Badgers win it 31-28 in overtime. Pressure, and Bechet does a miracle by just getting it away. And they have found something to get him free. Now that's bad news for Northwestern if he continues this, as Sutton takes it the other way and goes out over the 15. Here comes third down. Pressure off the edges. Throws the ball complete enough for the first down. Rashid Ward. And they double on Hood. The handoff goes to Sutton, and he still was a part of slowing down the play. Second down and 9. Sutton gets it. Boy, the Tigers are doing a great job of collapsing on him.
Run game's not working like it was in the first half.
Low pass, trouble, hit from behind, and he goes down. Bechet is very fortunate not to have fumbled the football. Okay. Australian kind of kick, but it's a line drive, and he'll catch it and have some room to run. And got to be tackled as he crosses the 50. So Macklin scaring everybody to death. Daniel looking, going to be sacked. Wooten, Corey Wooten.
Bates tells the front seven, get after it. You know it's going to be a pass.
Here comes pressure again. The ball thrown complete to Kaufman, and the big tight end will have the first down.
Led the Big Ten in sacks this year, so they can't get after the pass.
Blitz is on, hit at the ankles, and underthrows the ball, and very wisely so. Macklin behind center. He'll get the snap, and he'll pitch it back on a reverse to Perry. And Perry's got nowhere to run. That last hit was considerable just prior to that play. Looking, still looking, throws for the far sideline, just throws it away.
Wow.
A 48 yards at the last 12 seconds. Proves that he can. This is a great coverage kick. Very high, and is caught by Missouri at the 1 yard line. Tommy Saunders. Well, they have a fullback in the ballgame. It's Sutton lined up behind him. Missouri crowds at the line of scrimmage, and flags are down. The officials saying that they moved first.
Ball start, 89 offense, half the distance to the goal line.
But not so.
First down is a factor
again, and they go straight ahead with the quarterback sneak, and he will inch out.
Your block point is now at 10 yards instead of about 13,
but you're aided with the Australian kind of kick because you're on the move. Pass thrown complete. Peterman, first down. Boy, put an asterisk by that one.
Quarterback for 2 games.
Here's Sutton, rides him into the line, and then he gets overhauled. First of all, Sean Weatherspoon.
They could play in the Big 12 and beat Missouri.
Well, they got a chance tonight. Pass thrown. It is caught, and a flag comes down late. And, boy, that's thrown by the referee. And from
holding 62 of the offense, half the distance to the goal line, repeat second down.
The hold on to the football. 7:18 remaining. Pressure, and he is hit. The ball is another flag comes down. To the
holding
numbers on the field.
62 offense, half the distance to the goal, repeat second
Kennedy
down.
Kennedy gets now.
Still second down. They give it to Sutton. Running room, breaks it into the secondary. 15, out to the 20.
20, and it's going to be a third down, and it'll be about 4.5. They need the 25. Quick pass. It is dropped. Who caught it? Here comes the kick. Now this one is low, and more. That hit the back of a Missouri player, did it not?
Yes, it did.
And they have gotten on the ball at the 48-yard line. A scrimmage from the 48-yard line. 5:56 left in our ball game. Missouri trailing by 3. Blitz coming off the corner, and Daniel's going to run it, and he will go down after about a 4-yard gain with what they're going to be doing here. Man in motion again, and he hands it off to Macklin. They come to the near side, 45 at the 40, still inbound. Nope. The official right there said no, he stepped out of bounds and a yard earlier than that. Daniel, far sideline, throws it, and that one is just way too tall. Rather than north and south, they have not hurt them vertically, really. Going to try it this time, though. And the ball overthrown and almost intercepted at the 9-yard line by McManus. That is Chase Kaufman in the slot on the right. Do they look for him? I would think so. Yes, that's who they go to, and he makes the catch. So a wonderfully, wonderfully big target to throw to. 3 wide receivers to the right, 2 to the left. New set of downs at the 25. Pressure, and Wooden goes down, and the ball just thrown away. Missouri trails it by 3. Hands it off to Washington. Goes to the right side. Is going to squeeze out a couple of yards. Still fighting. Maybe a gain of 3. The secondary moving around, and now the linebackers drop off a little bit more. And they hand it off to Washington. It takes it to the right side. Good heavens, did he take a hit at the 19-yard line. They need to take it to the 15, and they will go for the field goal. Wolford, this one will go down from 37 yards away. He's already made one from 31, one from 43. Good snap. Plenty of distance, and he is good. We are tied with 2:49 left in the ball game. They've been kicking it deep to the left side. Let's see if they go there again. And he does. This is a boomer straight away. And it's going to go 3 yards deep, and very wisely, with only 2:49 left in the ball game. I figure they need to get to about the 30, 32-yard line. Boucher hands the ball off to Sutton. Going to go straight forward for a couple.
Under 2 minutes, you go out of bounds. It stops the clock. Plenty of time.
Boucher holds the pocket, throws it complete, and stepping out of bounds is Brewer. Huge one right here. Sutton relocates to the left of his quarterback. They roll the pocket that way, and the ball is thrown too high. Peterman, the intended receiver, and it's now fourth down. Will he move to his left? Takes a step to his left and kicks this one lower. And it's going to hit the ground, and it is surrounded by Northwestern players. So Missouri is going to be 67 yards away following that 40-yard kick. Here's Chase Daniel. Under pressure. Going to run it. Has 5. Has almost 10 yards in the play. In fact, he is very close to a first down.
He can take off and run, so Mike Hankwitz is stuck in a tough spot.
Waits to throw, gets this one away, has it to his big tight end, Kaufman. Has the first down, plus about 9 yards. Daniel, pressure from the outside, throws it complete. And that is Saunders, and Saunders will be tackled at the 42-yard line. Oh, here we go. On a second down and 5, Daniel, alone in the backfield. Good protection, got the pass, throws it complete. Good for the first down, and now here comes a blank. That could be a base mask.
That's completely inaccurate.
Personal foul, face mask.
Wow.
On the defense.
What a huge call.
That's an automatic first down.
Thing is, he does not have a running back there with it. And no one comes in motion, so he'll carry it. And Daniel is going to go down under pressure, losing a yard at the 24. Chase Daniel is actually going to go under center. We'll take it and move it to exactly on the field where they wanted it to be, which was a little bit more to the left. Well, he's already made 3 tonight. Can Wolford ice it for Chase Daniel and all the seniors, and also win it for the Big 12 Conference? Gets a good pass. Plenty of distance. He is no good. Wide to the right and no good.
What's it going to be, son?
Heads.
Heads, he said. Heads, he said. It is a tail. It is a tail. Northwestern has won the toss. Would you like to go on offense, defense, or choose the end of the field? Which
will go on defense, sir.
You want to go on defense? That means you're going to play offense. Which end of the field you want to play on? You're going to play on that way?
Well, first down from the 25. Well, you still have to contend with him as a ball carrier, and he's off and running. And shoved out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
Was accurate and on time. Now let's see if he can stay in that rhythm.
Chase will hand this one off to Washington. He gets banged hard, but he's going to take it for about four and a half. Washington again. Reverses. Nothing to the right. Goes back to the left again, and he's going to be tackled at around the 7-yard line. Plenty of time on the play clock. Boy, fumbled it. Over the middle. Throws the touchdown. Wow. Macklin. And Daniel was fumbling the football. Still had the presence to maintain and get the pass away. And now, good pass. Extra point is right down the middle. The time of the Wildcats. And remember this, cannot have a turnover or the game's over. Bechet fakes the pitch. He's got to keep it and go down to the 19-yard line. Pressure from the backside. Throws it complete. Peterman, first and goal inside the 10, Northwestern. Stack receivers, three to the right. But they roll it the other way, and he throws the ball under throws because he had to get rid of it. Quarterback draw, and now it is going to be third down and goal. He took it to around the 8-yard line. They got to score a touchdown if they don't get one here. Here comes pressure from the outside, and he is hit as the ball is thrown. It's recovered by Northwestern. It is a turnover, and it is fourth down at the 32-yard line. And Sean Witherspoon is the man.
I think you got to leave at least one guy short running across the middle in case nobody's open around the 10-yard line to see if he can get it in.
Now, here we go. Pressure from the outside. Going to go for it all at the end zone, which he has to do. And the ball is knocked down. In fact, may have been intercepted by William Moore. And the Missouri Tigers, they call it incomplete, have come from behind and have won over the Northwestern Wildcats. Chase Daniel overcoming. You just heard him say it. This game had to be won by my teammates in spite of me with three interceptions in the final 30-23. Brent Cunningham, Jack Arud, and our entire ESPN crew.